Look, I'm not somebody that just hates.
Hello, my baby.
That's real. That's a real trailer.
Hey, sorry about the technical difficulties.
I cannot believe some of the things that I am seeing surrounding Borderlands 3, but I think that these problems are indicative of much wider issues across gaming. Now, as most of you know, at this point, Borderlands 3 was officially announced. We've known it's been in development for a long time. There have been rumors and there have been leaks, but Randy Pitchford and the Borderlands team showed up at PAX to put on a really weird jacket and put on one of the strangest conferences I have ever seen in my life. Maybe it would be better to call it some sort of weird panel, but it was definitely not something that Gearbox had planned to go as horribly as it did.
So, you won?
They're gonna make sure this video works before we do the next thing.
This little mini conference will probably go down as one of the weirdest showings from a developer ever. There were terrible jokes, there were a huge amount of technical issues, there were pauses in this little mini announcement conference that made zero sense, there were an incredible amount of awkward moments, weird things that were said, and it all culminated in a few announcements. One was a Bulletstorm Switch port.
Next for you guys, I got something for you.
A Borderlands 1 remaster, and a Borderlands 2 and pre-sequel 4K update. But that's not what anybody was there for. Everybody, including my friend Jordan, who you're about to see, was there for one announcement and one announcement only, Borderlands 3. After a huge amount of trial and error on the parts of everybody working at PAX, including the people at Gearbox, a trailer was shown. Not just once, because it went poorly, but twice.
Please help me out, you guys. I love PAX, but come on. We should have brought our own equipment, right? Can we do it, you guys? So how's it going? Thanks for hanging for a second.
And this trailer was what everybody expected. It was new Borderlands. There were new enemies. There were guns that were walking around on legs. There were giant Ferris wheels. There were new characters. There were old characters. There were new powers. And of course, the tagline of billions of guns, as we've seen before. Now, anybody that's played the first Borderlands, more importantly, the millions of people that have played over the past 6 or 7 years Borderlands 2, know exactly what Borderlands is and is supposed to be. It is the loot shooter that really started the loot shooter multiplayer trend. The game that set the stage for things like The Division, Destiny, and Anthem to exist. It's a game that is wacky, it is chaotic, it is ridiculous, and it takes place in one of the most unrealistic fantasy wastelands you could possibly imagine. These are all of the game's strengths. But there were a lot of people in position of influence that were not at all happy with what they saw. Articles came flooding in from Forbes and Polygon talking about how they were upset, they were saddened, they were disappointed by the showing of Borderlands 3. That the game looked to be just more of the same, that it wasn't going to be good because this was just going to be even more Borderlands 2. These are actual articles, one that you're seeing on screen right now, about the Borderlands 3 reveal. Now, anybody with half a brain knows just how ridiculous this is, but again, it's indicative of a wider problem in gaming. See, journalists try to get out ahead of sentiment. They think they know oftentimes what people want, when in reality, they are very much so removed from the actual Congress of gaming. They have bosses to answer to. They have organizations, companies that own them. They're just as much marketing as the game companies are themselves. And in a way, this makes things really tough. It often puts them in no-win situations, but these articles are not the results of those realities, they're the results of people not understanding the climate. Look, I'm not somebody that just hates mainstream journalism just for the sake of hating mainstream journalism. Everybody, everywhere has had controversial opinions. I'm a YouTuber, I have controversial opinions all the time. I have popular opinions all the time. That's not new, that's just life, that's discourse, that's debate. But there is something inherently wrong with taking something that's nothing more than basically a pre-rendered trailer and debasing an entire franchise using it. This isn't a case of Anthem, which before it came out had well-known development issues, was coming from a publisher that was also well-known for doing terrible things, and had people who had gotten their hands on the game say that the game had problems. This is not that. This is a game that has been in development for 5 years, from a studio that outside of Battleborn has a pretty stellar track record when it comes to loot shooters, and it's a game that does exactly what people want, flies in the face of trends. All people wanted from Borderlands 3 is exactly what was shown at PAX. Nothing more and nothing less. They wanted more Borderlands. You know the thing that was so great that it is one of the most successful games of its genre ever? The game that created its own mini subgenre. All people wanted was more of that. Let's not forget that the pre-sequel was not that well received, in part because it strayed too far away from the formula that made Borderlands so maniacally wonderful in the first place. What we saw at PAX was a game that looked to be the natural evolution of what really comes next for Borderlands. Something that was prettier, something that sounded better, but even more importantly, something that fixed some of the game's glaring issues. The Wasteland looked far less empty than it ever has. It looked dense, it looked varied, it looked interesting for the first time since the pre-sequel. There was a lot of empty space in Borderlands 2. There was a lot of uninteresting locales in Borderlands 2, and this, in just one trailer, looks to be more unique and varied than that entire world was. A world that, by the way, was still awesome. Better yet, it amped up what makes Borderlands so unique, the craziness, a gun with legs, let's not forget that, the powers. This is a game that doesn't take itself too seriously. In the trailer, there was a moment where there was a saxophone solo. That's what Borderlands is about. So many people have been referencing things like, well, is it gonna have a battle royale, or why doesn't it have a new multiplayer mode, a competitive mode, or isn't the Borderlands universe great for battle royales? No.
What is this next Borderlands game? You know, it's gonna be like battle royale or something. Battle royale games are fun. That's not what we're making.
I put up a poll on Twitter. That Twitter poll said very simply, do you want a battle royale from Borderlands 3 or a battle royale Borderlands game? And the overwhelming sentiment was no, they would riot. I'm talking over 80% picked that option. Games journalists are so wrapped up in the things that are most popular. Even YouTubers, even content creators get caught up in it sometimes. It's hard not to. A lot of times it's because these things are popular because they're fun and enjoyable and people want to talk about them. But you can't project the successes of those things, those immensely popular things, onto other genres, onto other games that simply don't need them. And this isn't a uniquely Borderlands 3 problem. Not at all. I want to take a second to bring in my friend Jordan here, who intimately knows the Nintendo community, to talk about exactly how often we see things like this in the Nintendo community from the fans themselves. Fans that see change and are unhappy with it. And I'll let Jordan give you a few specific examples.
Hi everyone, my name is Jordan Fringe. If that name somewhat rings a bell, it's because I help clean prints here every once a week or so, edit a video. This is the first time I've been on camera. And today we wanted to kind of talk about this whole comparison of what to expect and over expectations and judging something for what it is, even though that's the thing you want. So briefly before we get into that, I am a huge Borderlands fan. I was actually at PAX East 2019 in the actual panel when they announced Borderlands 3. They gave out these masks. They're pretty cool, but plastic, but still something nice for them to give out. And I know how awkward the panel looked to the outside from the live streams, because yes, there were technical difficulties. There were a lot of problems, a lot of moments that may have dragged on for just a bit too long, but the panel was a lot more exciting being there, and it was fun being there with what the cameras and the audio didn't pick up, made it seem like it was a lot less exciting and definitely a lot more boring. I mean, heck, at least it felt like 20 minutes of what they took up time with this whole magic trick just to basically tease this Borderlands Tiny Tina's Robot Tea Party board game. We know Randy, and maybe some magic tricks should be left out of certain things. Disclaimer, that's just a joke, all right? Relax. And when I personally saw the Borderlands 3 trailer, I was tearing up. This is exactly what I've wanted. I'm gonna talk about my own personal stuff with Borderlands on my channel pretty soon, probably later this month, of what the first Borderlands game means to me. And actually, it just got remastered finally after 10 years, and now it's put on new consoles, which is amazing. But this third trailer made me tear up. It's everything I wanted Borderlands to be. It kept the cel-shaded look. Yes, it doesn't look terribly different, but it does look like there's more detail and a lot more to do, which is the point of a sequel. Specifically, this game right here, it's the perfect continuation, the perfect sequel. Especially when the property has established that this is the look that it goes for and this is what they want it to do. If they turned it into this super realistic looking game, or took the genre and said it's not a loot shooter anymore, made it a battle royale type game, or anything different than what it automatically was, that would have been a huge, massive uproar to everyone. And to see game journalists being vicious and vindictive towards what we saw here doesn't make any sense to me. Borderlands 3 is Borderlands 3. and somehow that's a problem. Now let's apply this to a couple other examples where this does and maybe doesn't work. So back right at the end of February, we had the announcements for both Pokemon Sword and Shield, and a lot of people were expecting some revolutionary type Pokemon game for the Nintendo Switch. And a lot of other people kept their expectations tempered because it's a Pokemon game. And when they announced Pokemon and I got to see the first look at it, I was happy. It looked like a Pokemon game. It looked like there was more to do and the graphics were fully fleshed out for the Nintendo Switch. It wasn't the biggest leap from the 3DS games. It wasn't the biggest leap from Pokemon Let's Go. It just looked like a solid Pokemon game. And while a lot of people were happy with that, that it's not straying too far from the formula, it's giving you that core RPG experience that they promised when they said before even Let's Go came out that you will get a real full-fledged Pokemon RPG experience in 2019, there was a lot of people on the other side that were not happy, that were extremely disappointed, that this should have been the big moment, that they should have literally gone and made something different. But that in there itself lies the problem. The Pokemon company, tried and true, knows what works and what sells. They can put Pokemon on literally anything, and you will probably buy it as a Pokemon fan. That does not mean that they didn't pour a lot of time into Sword and Shield, creating the new Pokemon, the new Galar region, all this nice, awesome stuff for Pokemon Sword and Shield. This is more of Game Freak realizing that this is not the moment to jump the shark. They know that if they do something too extremely different, the majority of the fan base wouldn't be happy. But for them to keep it pretty similar to what we've seen before, just with a lot of new things, and for the most part, we have seen nothing, I think was the smarter move, at least for the first real mainstream Pokemon game for the Nintendo Switch. We see this with the generations before in the 3DS, where they start off with some new enhancements and it looks something new and different, but it's still the same. But by the end of that system's life cycle, the final Pokemon games that come out are completely different. They look different. They play different. They have their own new set of rules while still keeping it traditional with small evolutions each time. And from what we've seen, that just looks like what we're getting here from this jump onto the Nintendo Switch from the 3DS. And while there are certain things I agree and disagree with what should have been in the game or what shouldn't be in the next game, it is what it is, and we also don't know too much about what it is. And I hope that what I'm saying here makes sense. In a way. And this is in no way me telling you your opinion of what you think of a certain thing is right or wrong. That's your opinion and we're all allowed to have them. But going back to Borderlands 3, you look at the articles that come out saying Borderlands is more Borderlands and that's bad. When already from the one trailer they've released and then the announcement trailer a few days later, you have seen so many improvements if you even stepped foot in Pandora or in either of the games or on the moon in the pre-sequel just once. There is a vast amount of differences. There are now worlds to go to, not just Pandora. There's a bunch of new characters, new enemies, vast variety, so many new things that are in the game and so many little snippets of stuff that if you slow down the trailer and look for, you will find there are female psychos in the game now. That is something that people have asked for that has not been put in there. It may be a small thing, but to some, that's a really awesome improvement. The variety of characters that they've shown, the new powers, the awesome stuff that they keep adding and switching up looks fantastic. And like Clean Prince said, the gun with legs. What? I wouldn't have even thought of that if I was on the biggest acid trip of my life. And I don't do acid. Don't do that, kids. And it's stuff like that that shows me that over the past 5 years, there has been a lot of work that has went into Borderlands 3. A lot of care, a lot of passion, a lot of thought, and a lot of talented ideas that are being implemented here just off of what we saw. And that is barely anything of what we're going to get. So let's take Animal Crossing, for example. We're getting a new Animal Crossing game later this year. And what if they decided to announce it and it's an RPG? What if it's something completely different? Would you be happy that there's this, oh, they turned it into something new, that's awesome, I'm into it? Or would you be disappointed that it's not Animal Crossing? The ones you've already played throughout the series that have basically been the same, except from small little differences and the graphical upgrades, would you want that to continue because that's the core of Animal Crossing? That's what makes Animal Crossing, Animal Crossing. Why would you want it to be a battle royale? Or an RPG, honestly, if there was an Animal Crossing Battle Royale. It's weird, but You piqued my curiosity. Okay, let's take it to something that where it makes sense to change it up, because look at the Legend of Zelda series. For the most part, aside from maybe like one or two different art styles, every single Legend of Zelda game has had a new art style, a new look to all the characters, or something different about them that makes every game unique, aside from maybe one or two games having a similar or the same exact art style. Look at Breath of the Wild. It looks nothing like Wind Waker. Wind Waker looks nothing like Twilight Princess. Twilight Princess looks nothing like Phantom Hourglass, and Phantom Hourglass looks like nothing of Ocarina of Time. They all have their own unique look to them, and that's what makes them special. But if they just said, hey, Breath of the Wild is the definitive look now, and kept doing Breath of the Wild 2, 3, and the next Zelda game looked like that, and all of them just kept it looking like that, you would get tedious. You'd be disappointed that they're not implementing new ideas. Now, while Breath of the Wild is great, you don't want to ruin something that was special for that game. That's what cements that particular game and its place in history. Now, of course, I would love a Breath of the Wild 2 and continue that art style, but to go on it further from there and implement it in a different Legend of Zelda series, it would be weird. So take Link's Awakening, the art style of that, where it looks like little clay figures walking around, which is a remake from the top-down version, which looks incredible. It's new, it's fresh, it makes an old game feel great, but keeping the true essence of what that game was, and it looks nothing like any other game on the market right now. So for that example, the changing of everything and making things different applies to it. But something like an Animal Crossing, and to somewhat of an extent, Pokemon, and obviously Borderlands, doesn't make sense. And to be upset about it kind of confuses me. So hopefully I laid that out in terms that are understandable, to where a lot of people think that this Borderlands argument is kind of ridiculous. And this is not to hate or to throw shade on anyone who is saying that they're disappointed from what we've seen from Borderlands. It's the argument that Borderlands is Borderlands, so that means it's bad because it didn't evolve into something else. Anyway, like I said, my name is Jordan Fringe. I've been talking for way too long. Let's get back over to Clean Prints. Feel free to check me over at my channel, Jordan Fringe. There's probably a link somewhere down below. You probably see me in the comment section. I do videos on Pokemon, Animal Crossing, and some Borderlands stuff coming up, so feel free to come over there and check me out. I appreciate it. Thanks for having me on, and I'll see you hopefully soon.
Look, here's what I have to say to, I guess, summarize the realities that are present here. There are games that are great as is. There are games that do their best in sequels when they're being the better version of what they already are. Not everything needs a battle royale, and it's shocking to me that so many people want to see games, genres, franchises mold into whatever is modern and popular. That stagnates genres. It stagnates industries. Innovation comes to a halt when everything becomes a clone of everything else. What makes Borderlands so special is that it's unique, it's individualistic, it is entirely idiosyncratic, and if we begin to lose that because so many people want it to be every other game, especially in positions of influence, then pretty soon we won't have any more Borderlands. We won't have any more change. We'll get the same games over and over again until the end of time. Well, guys, that is it for today's video, and as always, start of a dialogue. What do you think of this whole mess? What do you think of Borderlands 3? Is this what you want? Do you want to see more Borderlands, or do you want something else entirely? Do you want a Borderlands Battle Royale? Let me know the answer to any of those questions down in the comments below. Let's have a real conversation. As always, if you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. If you are not yet subscribed, hit that subscribe button. I put out gameplay analysis and examinations multiple times a week, so maybe you'll catch some of that, but hit subscribe so you don't miss any of it. And yeah, guys, that's it. As always, thank you to Jordan for being a part of this video. He features on this channel usually every third or fourth video. Jordan will play a part. Great guy. Check out his channel. Jordan Fringe makes incredible content. Yeah, there's Jordan somewhere. He's being beautiful. There he is. Yay, Jordan. That's it, guys. Until next time, I'm out.